Greetings from A. Shah's Institute. I would like to let you know that we are starting with the virtual platform for school students appearing for scholarship examinations. So, in this lecture, I'll let you know with the very basic and introduction about the scholarship examination. To for the free trial, please visit our website. Okay. So now, I would also like to let you know that we have five branches: Fort Paithani, Dadar, Thane, Nellore. If you can reach there, we will be very glad with you. But if not, then surely give us a call. We'll help you out with anything. And yeah, you can even apply online for this course. Okay. So now, first, I'll let you know about this examination. First, this examination about a year ago, it was named as Middle School Examination. And recently, it has been changed with pre-upper primary scholarship examination, and even the exam pattern has been quite changed. And each eligibility is 12 years to 15 years for categories, and for general categories is 12 years. So this exam is conducted on third Sunday of February every year. And you can enroll for this examination in fourth standard or fifth standard. It's totally fine, but the examination is given in standard four. Okay, so now the scholarship examination has been well versed with us by Maharashtra State Education Council, and now we look forward about the exam pattern of this scholarship examination. I would also like to tell you that every year 15 lakh students apply for this exam, enroll themselves for this exam, and yeah, the passing rates are quite difficult, but still we'll not lose our hope and we'll try our best. Okay, so for the exam pattern, I'll let you know there are two papers. First paper consists two subjects, first language and mathematics, and the number of questions for first language is 25 and marks for that is 50, and mathematics questions are 50 questions will be asked, which is 100 marks. For that you will be given 1 hour and 30 minutes to solve paper one, okay, including both the subjects. Then paper two consists of third language and intelligence test. Third language is Marathi, and intelligence test is obviously, intelligence test consists 50 questions for 100 marks, and third language consists 25 questions for 50 marks. Okay, so total of paper 1 150 and total of paper 2 150, that is 300 marks paper is scholarship exam is of 300 marks. Okay, for both of the papers, 1.5 hour timing is given individually. Now we'll know the difficulty level of questions. Easy questions are 30%, medium level of questions are 40%, and difficult questions which are asked is only 30%. So even if you are not able to attempt difficult questions, my dear, please don't worry. You can apply for easy questions and medium level questions. That is totally fine. And yeah, I'm happy to know that there are no negative markings in this examination. So you all can resume for this examination. There is no hurdles. Okay, no hurdles for you. So now, paper one, first language is English. So we'll see what are the topics with syllabus and what are the chapters. Okay, so first unit, which is vocabulary, it has weightage of 16% in the paper. So all of out of the 100% paper, 16% is given vocabulary. Now vocabulary has inside the subunits, that is, first is word formation, then homophones, prefix and suffix, antonyms, synonyms, compound words, one word for many, figurative words, name of young ones, professions, jumbled spellings, word puzzles, arranging alphabetical order, words denoting different sounds, singular and plural, and prepare short words from long words. Okay, so this 15 subtopics consist 16% of weightage in the whole paper. After that comes word games. That is the second unit, and it consists of puzzles, word register, related words, and match the words in pictures. So this is very fun loving unit, and you can really enjoy this. Then comes grammar. Now grammar is the part which will also help you further in your own syllabus, in your own school syllabus. So this is the content where you can get more knowledge, and you can apply it not only in the scholarship examination, but yeah, your syllabus exams too. Okay, so part of speech is there first, in which nouns, their types, there are many types of nouns, but yeah, here are only four types which is asked. There are common noun, proper noun, collective noun, and abstract noun. After that comes pronouns. Their personal pronouns is being asked. Adjectives, degree of comparison. Then verbs, conjugation of verbs, and action verbs and auxiliary verb is being asked. After that comes adverbs. After that, prepositions and conjunctions. These are the topics for parts of speech which will be asked. This parts of speech is the first subunit. After that comes articles. In articles, vowels and consonants are going to ask. And the third subtopic is parts of sentence, that is subject, predicate, questions, WH questions, and verbal questions is being asked. The fourth unit is language study, and in that the subunits are punctuation marks, contracted forms, expanded forms, idioms and phrases, proverbs, slogans, idioms, follow instructions, road signs, phrases, elements in story, tenses, which consists present, past, future, and makes meaningful sentences. This carries 4% of weightage for this 10 subunits for unit language study. Okay. After that comes creative writing. Creative writing will not be in your syllabus at the standard of 5th, but it's totally fine. You'll learn now, and it is gonna help you for your further standards. Okay, so 16% of weightage is given to creative writing. This creative writing includes subunits like give titles, captions, headlines of news, story pictures, cartoons, leaflets, then paragraph writing, stories, processes, events, experiments. Then comes autobiography, short autobiography of a thing or an object. And then comes informal letters. So in this creative writing, you'll get to learn a lot, and you'll get a more exposure towards the English language. Okay. After that comes unit 6, that is reading skills. It is a comprehension type. Obviously, the paper will be theory, you have to write the paper, but in that reading skills, where you'll be given a passage or something, from that you have to solve the questions and you have to give them the answers, the correct answers you have to opt. Okay, then this unit consists 24% of weightage of the whole paper. Okay, so first is informative, descriptive, narrative, and imaginative passage. So these are the four options. From these four options, any one of the options will be count as a passage. Okay. Then comes news items, advertisement, and leaflet. And after that is short skit, interview, and poem. So this is the unit 6, and now we'll look for unit 7, which is miscellaneous, in which numbers, cardinals, and ordinals. Like cardinals is 1, 2, 3, and ordinals like 1st, 2nd, 3rd. In this manner, it's gonna come. Then comes non-English words, read maps, charts, stock expressions, and abbreviations. Okay, so and this weightage for unit 7 is 8%. Then comes, I would like to know what are the courses we offer for online courses, which is virtual platform for the school students is Maharashtra Pragna Shodhak Pariksha for standard second and standard fourth. Standard fifth, as I told you, pre-upper primary scholarship examination. Even standard sixth, we give Maharashtra Pragna Shodhak Pariksha, same for standard seven and standard eight pre-secondary scholarship, which is high school secondary scholarship. Okay. Then for ninth standard, there is Maharashtra Talent Search Examination, and standard 10th comes National Talent Search Examination. Standard 10th is this talent search examination has various two levels. One comes Maharashtra, the one who clears this Maharashtra Talent Search Exam goes to National Talent Search Exam. I would like let you know that till 9th standard, there is no negative markings, but in 10th standard talent search exam, it consists negative markings. So next comes benefits of scholarship exams. Okay, so why you feel like giving scholarship exams? Here are some of the benefits which I am mentioning. So after in future, if you would like to go for MPSC, UPSC, any of the competitive examination, then this scholarship exams lays a foundation and strengthens your basic theories knowledge, and which will help you for further competitive examinations. Then comes power of analytical reasoning. So you'll get more exposure to think over, to give, because after that there are second paper is consist of intelligent test. This will give you more knowledge, and you'll be very well versed with many of the theories. Okay, then it helps in school exams too. As I said, grammar part will help you for other examinations. So this is not only about English but also about maths and various papers. There are other three papers too. So even those three papers will help you in your school exams too. Then comes development of self-confidence. Once you get more knowledge and you start getting confidence, like you'll appear for the examination. So during the syllabus pattern of your school or your further competitive examinations, yes, you will gain some confidence. No, my base is strong, so that you'll be able to learn more for it. Okay, then yeah, understanding is encouraged. Obviously, conceptual understanding is encouraged. With this examination, you'll get more knowledge, and you'll be able to understand each and every concept very clearly. Okay, so yeah, we are giving you online platform to prepare for this concept competitive examinations. With this, yes, your academic performance is improved, general knowledge will be enhanced, and yes, we'll be updating you online daily. Okay, and even you'll be saving time for not traveling, and you'll be able to do activities online. And yes, obviously for fun loving games and quizzes, we'll be surely giving you online daily. Okay, so regular participants will get young IAS certificates and very lovely prizes also. And yeah, if you are taking the online course, then yes, 20% discount also we are offering to you. For the first week of trial, you can visit our site, that is www.youngis.com, and also you can submit your inquiry in school section. Okay, so as I discussed, what are the benefits which you will get and how will you register with us? So you have to submit the form at the website, or else you can, for the free trial, you can SMS us the student's name, your student standard, their mobile number and email ID to the number given below. Okay, these are the various links through which you can know about us. And yeah, if you feel getting connection with us, yes, we are obviously open, and you can come anytime, and we are there to help you. So all the best for you all, and be prepared So we are going to start next lecture from the first vocabulary, first topic, vocabulary. So be prepared and see you soon. Okay, thank you.